let's change our thoughts.
Le gona a re tshentseng megopolo ya rena.
How you think about yourself?
Ka mogole nahanang ka bolena.
How you think about others?
Ka mogole nahanang ka batho ba bangwe.
How you think about your family
and
your future?
Ka mogole nahanang ka bokamoso le lapa la gena.
Jesus always addresses thoughts.
Jesu o dula bo le dishana le megopolo.
Thoughts are so important.
Megopolo ke ntwe ya botlhokwa nase.
Thoughts are the voice of your spirit.
Megopolo ke lentswe la moya wa lena.
So you know your spirit by what you think.
O ka tseba moya o leng mo go wena ka mogopolo.
God is going to judge us by our thoughts.
Taba e ta nkwešišong ya gore ke bolele gore modimo o tla thola megopolo ya rena.
Whatever you are saying out to people around you.
Tse o di bolelang o boledišana le batho ba leng gaoswe.
It might not be mean what you mean.
E ka ba e sa thalose se wena o reng o ya se thalosa.
But if we can search your thoughts, we'll find who are you and where are you standing? What is it that Jesus is saying concerning your thoughts?
Ke eng se Jesu a se bolelang o ya ka megopolo ya lena?
Change how you think.
Tshentsha ka mogonana.
You cannot maintain yourself in the will of God until
o ka sete tlhokomele mo thatong ya papa.
You are able to defy what will say.
O gona hanetsa se ba se bolela.
What they are thinking.
Ntho tse ba di nahanang.
It's very dangerous to think you know people.
Go go tse o nahana gore batho ya ba
tseba. Because you won't know the day God has touched their hearts.
Ka ba no ka se tsebele tsa tshelela modimo ba gwatang dipelo.
I don't know if you hear me.
Ka ke tseba le ntwa.
Sometimes we make mistakes of judging people who are in his will.
Tsa o hatula batho ba leng ka ratato ya papa.
Listen to this, you must be very careful of opening your mouth and think and talk about other people. This is the time now you stop thinking about the past lives of other people. Because you don't know now that God might be involved with them. This is the main reasons why many of you are saying you invited Jesus. He's in your house. The Bible is in your house. But you still have evil thoughts. This is the time of correcting your thoughts. And you change. Stop thinking what can defile you. If you still finding yourself say you love God.
How sad it tola ubulela ore ke rata modimo.
Not having the past of showing that you love God.
What's
or where you come
hale,
from. You can still be questioned. Because here the Bible shows that your love is determined by where you come from. And now if you are able to overcome and stand in his will, you can be declared you love much. But people of this little sins, they normally have thoughts about those who have sinned a lot. There's no miracle until you overpower what you have. So that you stand in his will. It's called faith when you are able to overcome what you have been told, the thoughts you had, and push them aside and say, I'm going to do what God wants me to do. Matthew 5, verse 28.
Our thoughts
are not separate with our focus. Our thoughts are our focus. Where you are looking, your thoughts are there. So your focus are based from your thoughts. Don't ever think you can just look somewhere and you're not thinking. What is it that you normally look at? If truly your thoughts are connected with your focus, check where you spend your time looking at. If you look unto the word of God, your thoughts are there. And now your focus is in the word. And now you change your thoughts to be the word. Can you see that? Because a man becomes what he thinks. If you want to have the word of God, you look unto the word. And you spend time in the word. You think the word. You read the word. And now your thoughts, you are directing them to the word. Even your focus will be in God. Will be in the word. I don't know if you are hearing that. If you want God to help you today, there are some things you must stop thinking about. If you start to think about, I've got debt, oh, I don't know, those debts will increase. Those debts becomes your God, will control you. I don't know if you're hearing me. The problem you have today, the reason why now is going up.
Why do
because your focus is there. This is the time that we change our thoughts and we confine them to the word. We begin to think about the word when we are facing any challenge. Those challenges will change in front of our eyes. I don't know if you're hearing me. You cannot be intimidated when you are hearing a word that says, I'm with you. I'm with you. Your battle is my battle. Not your battle. Your battle is my battle. What is it that is troubling you? The problem is your thoughts are based on that. Change your thoughts. You will see what God will do. You will overcome. You will pass that level. You will go to the next level. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I don't know what is happening in your life. Remove your mind from what is happening to you. Look unto Jesus. He will take you there. If you believe, say amen. Change your thoughts. Change the way you think. And it will work for you. I say it will work for you. Luke 6. Verse 7. The victory that you need to have lies in the thoughts of your opposers. Matthew 15, verse 18 to 20. What makes you a sinner before God are your thoughts. And all these things are coming from your heart. They defile you. If you are defiled,
and how chill of a hair
can you still speak? You are a Christian, whereas God does not know you. To be defiled, it means you are a sinner. It means you are not part of God. To be defiled, it means you have got no connection
with God.
Many times we think we are Christians because we are coming to church. Our thoughts declare us. We are declared by our thoughts. And those thoughts, they have fruits. Change the way you think. Do you know that you are supposed to be competing anyone? Because God is involved in your life. So it's no longer you who lives. Christ lives in you. You're not supposed to be fighting anyone. Thinking about something, it's a waste of time. If you're a child of God, you'll understand that no one can stop you. No one can witch you. No one can block you. Because whoever fights you is fighting Jesus. No one can overcome God. No one. And the Bible says you are more than the conquerors in Christ Jesus. Some of supposed to be blessed. Right now, there's a delay. I'll tell you why there's a delay. Just deal with the way you think. Deal with the way you think. What you are praying for will come. I don't know if you're hearing me. Can you deal with the way you think?